upgraded your reports on the Scarlet Letter.
Ooh, ooh, what'd I get? An F.
Wow.
Just like Demi Moore in that movie. You know, the juror? Yes.
Now, class, I was very disappointed, I must say. Only one student got an A.
A B?
A B? Wow. It's like the first time in 10 years you got anything but an A. God, you must feel like dirt. Wait till I tell Paul Zimmerman, school reporter. All right, maybe I shouldn't say anything. I can keep a secret. By the way, did you know Zimmerman's gay? Did you hear about Amber's yeast infection?
Mr. Monteleone, there must be some mistake here. Oh, I get it. This is a joke. You guys, where's the camera? Is it April 1st?
It's no joke, Miss Malloy. Your grade is correct. Amber, you were the only one who got an A.
Wait till my parole officer hears about this. But I wrote an imaginative essay comparing Hester Prynne's struggle to the charges against Benazir Bhutto in modern-day Pakistan. All she did was write exactly what you said in class. Hester did a bad thing and was punished, as she should have been, the little tramp.
Well, I read it 40 years ago, and that's what I remember. Now, rather than weep about your grades, prepare yourselves for next week's oral reports. They will determine your final grade.
Mr. Monteleone, I still don't know what I did wrong here. I mean, isn't the whole point of reading books to form your own ideas, to stimulate thought, to interpret?
You're cutting into my coffee and cigarette time. Your grade is a B.
All right. I can handle a B. I'm not one of those kids that's driven and driven and driven to get an A no matter what. I can deal with a B. No, I can't!
What are you complaining about? I got staples in my chest. You don't see me crying.
Shut up!
Jack, and don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack, and don't you come back no more.
Oh, what you say?
Hit the road, Jack, and don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack, and don't you come back no more.
Oh, woman, don't you treat me so mean. You're the meanest old woman that I've ever seen. I guess if you say so, to pack my things and go.
That's right, hit the road, Jack, and don't you come back no more, no more, no more, no more. Hit the road, Jack, and don't you come back no more.
Oh, what you say?
Come on back. You gonna go to work today?
I don't feel like it.
Yeah. Would you like to do something with me? Yeah.
Well, I would, but it's a work day. What's wrong, sweetheart?
I got a B.
Honey, it's not your fault you're totally uncoordinated. You get that from Daddy.
It's not Jim, Mom. I get all A's in Jim. Ms. McGuire, or as she likes to be called, Butch, seems to really like me. She's very sweet and throws a heck of a shot put. My problem is in English. I got a B because I have my own opinions. This teacher just wants everything parroted back to him. He doesn't want people to think for themselves.
Is that what he wants?
Yeah. Anything he says about any book, you just repeat back to him and you get an A.
You mean anything that he says about any book, you just repeat it back to him and you get an A?
Exactly. Is that any way to learn?
Is that any way to learn?
Exactly! So now everything's riding on my oral report. I have to choose a book.
Oh, let me help you with your report, honey. I read constantly. Here's a few of my favorite books. Love's Passion. Passion's Love. A Slave for Sally. Oh, Fabio. I knew Fabio before he was Fabio, when he was still just a drawing. Why, I dreamt of him just last night. Fabio. Fabio!
So you're saying that... You weren't saying that I was fabulous in Italian. I mean, the way you were screaming, I thought I was hitting a home run.
No, honey, just a usual single up the middle.
Well, not a single up the middle. That was a triple. Or at least a double. Maybe a ground rule. Call it a sacrifice fly.
Here's my report card. All A's. That used to be me. Now I have a B. For bad.
I got an F. For phenomenal.
Kids are upstairs talking about their grades. As if grades had anything to do with the real world.
Yeah, you got D's and F's, and it didn't stop you from getting a cushy job at the used car lot. Bet you couldn't wait for your 20-year reunion, eh, Jack? Hey, it's Jack Malloy, the used car salesman.
Gee, I wish I married him.
I could be driving around in a 5-year-old Taurus. What?
You know, sometimes I wish I could go back to high school for a while.
I'd be just like those kids on 90210. They're my age. And I got more hair than that Dylan. And I'm a lot more fun than those kids on Party of Five.
A root canal is more fun than those Party of Five kids. You know, the entertainment industry could use a new action hero. They're all either too old, too fat, or don't speak English. Or, like Stallone, all three. Folks, introducing Rex Floppy. He takes his woman like Noah took his animals. Two at a time.
And I could be your trusty sidekick, Jake Malloy.
Who takes his women like he takes his pizza. Cold, greasy, and leftover.
When you're starving, anything tastes good. You know, Floppy, I think we really should make a movie. Just a nice little independent feature that we could get some nerdy executive to see at Sundance and then pay us $1 million, you know, to justify the ski trip.
I'm getting an idea. Two guys in a basement and a lot of naked girls come visit them.
I'd see it.
Penny Production.
So, are you ready to... cave in like the rest of us?
No. I'm not giving in to the intellectual fascism of Mr. Monteleone. I've done what great rebels have done throughout history. I tattled on the tyrant. I wrote a letter to the school board, and he should be out of here quicker than a Meryl Streep film is out of the theaters.
Well, class, I hope you have your oral reports ready. Remember, this is for your final grade. Today, Ryan Malloy is going to tell us why Herman Melville is the greatest author of all time. And about the novel Moby Dick, written in 1851 about a sailor chasing a big white whale. Ryan?
Herman Melville is the greatest author of all time.
Very good!
And, he wrote a book called Moby Dick, and it was about, a white whale, a big one, and, did I mention he was the greatest author of all time? A big one.
Darn near excellent, Mr. Malloy.
What about the fact that some say Melville beat his wife? Wouldn't it be thought-provoking to discuss whether we should judge a writer more harshly if he was a monster in real life? What about the parallels between Picasso and the new work on Bruno Bettelheim?
And what about my prostate? What's all this have to do with the price of tea in China? The only thing that's relevant is what I say is relevant.
We'll see about that.
Oh, we saw, Miss Malloy. Yes, I know about your little letter to the school board. They agree with you. but they can't do a thing about it, because no one wants this job. So long as I don't mention God in this classroom, I can't be fired.
You said the God word?
Who's going to believe you? God, 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 God. See, no one can stop me. I may not be able to afford a Geo Metro, but I can do this. Your paper deserves an A, but you get an F. Why? Because I can't pay my electric bill. I can do what I want. Not out in the world, where I'm just a crazy old man living on cat food and stealing apples from Lucky's. But in here, where I'm Michael Jordan, and you're just a bunch of cheap, interchangeable white guys. Here, I do whatever I want. Ryan Malloy, A. The rest of you will give your oral reports next time. Who knows, perhaps I'll be sober by then. Read the books if you want, but this is what they're about. I have found that it is better to read what I say first and then to just glance over the book, because then you know what you should be thinking. Or be prepared for a B, Miss Malloy.
But I want to go to Harvard.
You just have to do it my way.
Now that was a triple.
You barely beat out that bunt.
Hey, guys.
How'd it go in school?
Oh, this parroting thing really works great. It's a breakthrough, an epiphany. That's the right word, right?
Did you hear someone use it that way?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the right word. And how was your day, honey?
Dirt, duty, caca. I want an A.
All right, well, you better let me help you with your English homework. Here are Mr. Monteleone's opinions on all the books for the final exam. I looked them over and, he's right.
I can't believe this. He says that Joseph Heller's Catch-22 is a novel about World War II. Hello, Mr. Heller? Mr. Joseph Heller? Don't you think it's a little simplistic to say that Catch-22 is just a book about World War II? Isn't it about the timeless, universal struggle of the individual to survive in the face of an absurd, uncaring society? It's about World War II, huh?
Mom, Dad, nothing can stop me now. Before, I had no hope, but now I realize that as long as someone speaks first, I'm a genius. I understand the meaning of life. You just regurgitate other people's ideas. Or I could be a network executive. Let's see. Okay, we need a hit show, right? So Friends is a hit show. So we'll make a show like Friends, except with a twist. Instead of having three guys and three girls, mm-hmm. we'll make it three girls and three guys. And instead of having it take place at a coffee house, we'll make it a
juice bar.
I got it. A juice bar.
Yeah.
Oh, I like it. Wow, you should run a network.
Well, I hear there's going to be a big shakeup at ABC.
Yeah. Hello, Mr. Mailer. I just have a few questions about your book, The Naked and the Dead. No. No, I'm not naked. What does it matter what I look like? Yes, I'm sure you could drink me under the table. Now, about your books. Yes, you are the toughest living author. Next to you, Truman Capote was a big Nancy boy. You're a bear, Grr. Now, could we please get on with this conversation?
Fifth rock from the sun?
The moon.
None of these famous authors seem to care how I interpret their work. They're just happy I bought the hardcover. When they heard I lived in L.A., they wanted to pitch me a movie. Maybe I should just give in and play the game. I'll just do what everyone says.
Do what everyone says.
Do what everyone says.
It was
was a smoky night. The hot wind was blowing through my fur, and I was feeling more pressure than B. Arthur's bar stool. I was waiting for my partner, Jake, to arrive.
Howdy, partner.
Jack, what the hell are you doing? We're making a movie about 20-somethings who work in a video store, talk about life, and plan a bank heist.
I want to be a cowboy.
You can't.
Well, I want to.
Fine, you're a cowboy.
Gay.
So, when are the chicks coming?
Soon, Jack, soon. All right, take one. So here we are, two 20-something clerks in a video store, one of whom is a cowboy.
A man's man.
Well put, Jack. You know, a lot of this plot revolves around breasts. You did get some girls, didn't you?
You bet your little booties I did. I went down to the bus station and I handed out flyers. Young girls wanted, underline the word young. Nudity required, major motion picture. Come to my basement. I think I hear the girls coming now.
You're under arrest, sicko.
Look, officer, you got it all wrong. We're just making an independent film here. Tell him, Floppy.
We know all about your kind of films, mister. My daughter was in one.
You think she'd want to do another one?
Yep, it was a smoky night. And the only sound was the thump, thump, thump on the tender skull of a midnight cowboy. Fade out. Thank you.
So, in conclusion, you're saying that Hamlet is a play about a Danish prince. And at the end...
Hamlet is a play about a Danish prince. At the end, everybody dies, which teaches us that everybody dies.
Very good. Thank you, Alice. You get an A. In fact, everybody so far has got an A's. Well, if there's only one person left, I'm sure she won't let us down. I mean, with everybody getting A's, I'm sure the smartest person in the class will get one. Miss Malloy.
Hamlet is the best play ever. It has 5 acts. It is by William Shakespeare. It is about a Danish prince. At the end, everybody dies, which teaches us that everybody dies.
That's very good. And that's exactly what you think, isn't it?
Many scholars think that.
You don't think that Hamlet is really symbolic of something else? Some struggle inside all of us? You don't feel the need to compare him to, say, oh, Bill Clinton?
No.
I know you've had other thoughts before about all of this, but I think you can see this is a clearer, more concise, more accurate reading than yours, that your reading was completely wrong. Don't you think so, Miss Malloy?
Yes. No. I completely disagree. Am I the only one here who sees the irony in this? Hamlet's problem is that he thinks too much, yet no one in this class thinks at all. Just because a parrot says pretty bird, that doesn't mean that it is a pretty bird.
Pretty bird.
People write to be interpreted. The whole point of writing a book is to make people think for themselves, not just to spell it out for them. That's what TGIF is for. There's only 20 people left in the U.S. who actually enjoy reading. Don't break the spirit of one of them.
Which? Which? Which?
Pretty bird. Pretty bird.
Yes, I like to read and I admit it. And I like to think. And if you think that I don't deserve an A because I think, then you know what? I don't want your A.
I got a B. Oh, Mr. Montalioni gave me a B. My life is ruined. My perfect record is ruined. I got a B. A B, a B, a B.
Actually, you got a B minus. Which is pretty much a tarted up C plus. So, you pretty much got a C.
Jack, you think you ought to talk to her?
Nah, she'll get over it. It's not like it's gonna affect the rest of her life.
Is my little black dress ready for my funeral?
Yes, dear. She's dying.
Montalioni.
It's over. She's gone. Her final word was Montalioni.
Montalioni? What the hell does that mean?
Pretty bird!
Who let the president of ABC in here?
We're number 7 now.
Dear Mr. Floppy, how do you stay in shape? Monique G. Milan. Dear Monique, I know it's a cliche, but I have Derek, my personal trainer. Check out these guns. I got it all. Well, let's face it, it's all steroids and diuretics. Remember out there, kids, Mr. Floppy doesn't drink until the job's done. Job's done.